So in conclusion, when we talk about digitization, digitalization, and digital transformation, basically there are different strategies in response to the same digital revolution. So of course, we will ask, now, so how do I decide when and where to apply digitization or digitalization or digital transformation? I would say the answer would be how much we get out of digital transformation depends on how much we put into business transformation. So in other words, what are we trying to do with our business? So therefore, stage two of this digital journey is for us to clearly define what is our growth strategy, what is our competitive strategy into the future. Now, so what is our growth strategy today and the next 5 to 10 years? So this is a question we have to ask, we have to find the search for the answer. Then at the same time, what is our competitive strategy today and into the future? So for example, today, how do I remain cheaper than those who are better than me, better than those who are cheaper than me? And since the cheaper are getting better and the better are getting cheaper all the time, how can I adapt faster than all of them? So being cheaper, better, and faster. So how am I CBF today and how do I intend to remain CBF into the future? And we put the two together, growth strategy and the competitive strategy. Here we are in 2021. How am I growing? How am I competing? And come 2030, how do I intend to grow? How do I intend to continue to compete for a bigger share of the industry? So here I use Las Vegas as an example. My first visit to Las Vegas was in 1976. That year, they had 9.8 million visitors. Now, the main attraction of Las Vegas at that time was casino, and the main visitors were the gamers. Of course, Las Vegas wanted to grow many times bigger, so they have to pursue a new growth strategy, a new competitive strategy. And this is what they came up with, right? From the gamer to entire family, from casino to wholesome entertainment for the entire family. Now, so once we have the growth and competitive strategy formulated, the next step is to identify what are the key bottlenecks. Key bottlenecks meaning that what could stop us from achieving what we aim to achieve in our growth strategy, in our competitive strategy. So when we talk about the bottleneck, we can look at supply side bottleneck or demand side bottleneck. So most organizations, when they are not doing well, they have demand side bottleneck. And when they are doing well, they have supply side bottleneck. Then the other dimension is, are these internal or external bottleneck? So for example, if you look at global supply chain, the bottleneck may not be within my organizations, but between me and my business partner. So with this framework in mind, we can identify a bottleneck in product, services, customer, channel, as well as the core competency, innovation, and so on. Now, it's important that we are honest with ourselves in identifying bottleneck, because always bear in mind that we are only as strong as our weakest link. So in the case of Vegas, having decided to go X time bigger, they were to identify what could be the potential bottleneck. Is it hotel rooms, theater seats, airline seats, and so on, right? Now, the next step is to identify what kind of breakthrough will be needed so that we can break this bottleneck. Now, in identifying breakthrough can come in both the form of digital transformation or non-digital transformation, and most likely a combination of both. Because at the end of the day, to achieve breakthrough, we have to look at the two dimensions of capacity and capability. Now, so if I want to achieve a breakthrough by using existing capacity and existing capability, then I will think about how to enhance the productivity of my same operation today. Or I can actually look into how can I make better use of my existing capacity by building new capability. So same, but better. Or I can think about how can I make more use of my existing capability by expanding on new capacity. So same, but bigger. And last but not least, building new capability and new capacity, bigger and better. So these are all various ways of breaking our bottlenecks. Now, as we identify this breakthrough, we must always bear in mind that all roads must lead to Rome. So therefore, all the breakthrough that we identify, they must contribute to our digital vision of the future. So in a way, we can organize all this breakthrough into what I call the application pillar. And application pillar, basically, they are our digital highway. And all of them must lead us to this digital future that we are creating, right? And of course, each of these application pillar will be supported by sub-pillar. So in the case of Vegas, they have identified four application pillar in the pursuit of a new vision, right? So these four application pillar are hotel, shows, attraction, and tour. Now, of course, all roads must lead to Rome, but we must also recognize that Rome was not built in one day. So in other words, we need to prioritize all these application pillar and even across the pillar by looking at least two dimensions, the risk factor and the impact factor. So for example, some may go for the lower risk with lower impact, so as a way of catching up with the competition, or some may go for higher risk even though less impact because they have the ability to manage the risk. Or some will go for the higher risk and more impact by spreading their risk, like OPM, other people's money. Or last but not least, to go for the lower risk, high impact by striving to be the pathfinder, the pioneer, the early adopters of the industry. So here we are. So we have all the application pillar, sub-pillar prioritized as shown by the color code. Now, so with that, we're now ready to enter the fifth stage of the digital journey, which is to create, co-create this digital architecture. Now, we can create this digital architecture by first converting this application pillar or that into a version zero of our digital architecture with a horizontal pillar, a beam, which is the application pillar that cut across the entire organizations, right? Then together with the other application pillar. But of course, areas of the pillar with higher priority, we can go on the fast tracking to identify the functionalities of this particular pillar of higher priority. Now, as we identify the functionality, we must also bear in mind that one main objective is to create this excellent UX user experience. So in other words, yes, we want the pillar, the functionality, to be able to meet the requirement of the users, but must do so in such a way that it's very easy, very caring for the customer, so that at the end of the day, our users will not only be highly satisfied, but also be emotionally engaged. So for example, I was so emotionally engaged by Blueground that today I'm one of the strong supporters and advocate of their product and services. Now, as we continue to fill in the functionality and strengthen the user experience across the various application pillar, you see that there's something missing, the foundation. So this foundation basically is our data platform. Right? So we identify the data that's needed to support the entire operation. Right? So here we are, a more complete digital architecture with the horizontal pillar, vertical pillar, as well as a data platform. So if you look at the case of the Vegas.com, it's a good example of a successful digital transformation because firstly, they have a clear growth strategy and clear competitive strategy. They have a clear identification of application pillar, and each of these pillars are very well designed, very easy to use, very emotionally engaging for the users, from the hotel booking to attraction booking to tour booking and so on. In fact, 2 years ago, me and my wife, we planned a trip to Vegas. We made use of these apps. We were able to plan our trip. We were able to stay in the hotel that we like, watch the shows that we like, visit the Grand Canyon that we love, and most of all, visit this one of the most beautiful canyons in the world, the Antelope Canyon. And in fact, we came away so highly satisfied because the Vegas of today is completely transformed from the Vegas of the past, both in the non-DT way as well in the DT way. So in conclusion, now this digital revolution is here to stay. So organizations ought to take digital revolution seriously because it will make a big difference to the way we're able to grow in the future, able to compete in the future, able to succeed in the future. So what I intend to do is share with you not just the why, but also the what and how of having a successful journey on this digital transformation. These five stages of the digital journey is important that for the business leader and the digital expert to work together to go through the whole process together so that we can have the digital architecture that will enable us to get off to a good start on this journey of business transformation and digital transformation. This good start is very important because a good start is half the success. So with that, I wish you all the very best.